I'm Umbreon Labrus. When Dynamax was first announced, which, by the way, was over a year ago, can you believe it? Anyway, I wasn't a big fan of the idea. I'm generally not too into the big, flashy battle mechanics, Mega Evolution, Z-Moves, and Dynamax. As battle mechanics, I tend to find them pretty meh, because I feel like they give you too much of an advantage in standard gameplay. And every generation has been able to shake up battling even without flashy mechanics, like by introducing hold items, abilities, or the physical special split. You can watch the video that I did back then for my full thoughts on the topic, but of course, since then, we found out about Gigantamaxing and, you know, the games came out. So now I've actually experienced Dynamax, both in-game and in competitive situations, since this year was the first time that I've put any kind of real effort into online battles. So here is my final verdict on Dynamax and Gigantamax as mechanics and on the designs of Gigantamax forms. The lore of Dynamax is kind of boring. It's not very well developed, especially Gigantamax. Like, we know that the energy comes from Eternatus and it's tied to specific locations in Galar, but the fact that Dynamax is just an illusion is relegated to a freaking trainer tip sign. And as far as I can remember, there is no explanation for why some Pokemon have Gigantamax forms, or why some individuals can Gigantamax but not others. It's like they had this idea for a mechanic they really liked, but then didn't really bother to put much lore behind it, which is disappointing. The mechanic itself isn't so bad though. I still think that it's unnecessary, but as far as the flashy mechanics go, it's probably the one that's best implemented. I like that you can Dynamax any Pokemon, and in almost every situation where you can Dynamax, your opponent can and probably will too, except I guess in the Battle Tower. But at least in the stadiums, there is always going to be a Pokemon that your opponent will Dynamax, so it's not just you Dynamaxing and tearing through their team, there is some balance there. Unfortunately, it is very predictable when your opponent will Dynamax. It's always going to be their ace, their last Pokemon, and so the battles can get a little bit stale. But thankfully, that isn't the case when you're battling against real people. I've only done ranked in doubles, and I've heard people complaining about Dynamax in singles, but I think in doubles, it works pretty well. It is much harder to know when an opponent will Dynamax, or even which Pokemon they're going to Dynamax. And even with your own Pokemon, are you going to Dynamax your lead and get an early start, or are you going to set up and clear some obstacles first so that your Dynamax can have a late game sweep? One thing I really appreciate is that Dynamax is not just power. It's not just that you get three powerful moves. The extra HP is also really important, but the side effects of the moves are really critical. You can completely change how you play a Pokemon since you can set up weather or terrain or manage stats, and I feel like that level of strategy is more than what Megas or Z-moves had to offer. Gigantamax is much more of a mixed bag though. Not only is there no lore behind it, but some of the G-Max moves are actually worse than the regular Max moves. Like Corviknight's Windrage, it removes Light Screen, Reflect, Spikes, and Electric Terrain, and sure, that is good, but it's also way more situational than just getting a speed boost for you and your ally. But the thing that really makes me vehemently shrug about Gigantamax is the designs. I appreciate that there are new designs for old Pokemon, I really do, and I think it's great that they actually gave G-Max forms to Pokemon from Generation 8, unlike how they did Megas. Although the distribution of G-Max forms is really bad, there's only two Pokemon that are neither Gen 1 nor Gen 8, and one of those is Melmetal, which isn't even in the game yet. But the designs themselves just do not excite me at all. It's not even that they are bad designs necessarily, it's just that the vast majority of them take the designs in a direction that is both over the top and kinda silly. Like Garbodor, for example. It goes from looking like a large garbage bag to looking like an entire landfill pile big enough to hold ships and buildings, except that they're toys? So why are the toys huge? Like, if they weren't toys, it would still be excessive, but at least it would make a little bit more sense. The starters aren't much better. Rillaboom uses its hair to play on a forest-sized drum set. Inteleon uses a sniper rifle from a tower made up of its own tail. Cinderace stands on a giant fireball that looks like Ball Guy. Charizard's wings are fire. Venusaur looks like it's getting crushed by the weight of its own flower, and Blastoise is like a tank or a turret of some kind. There's two designs that I really don't like, or, well, three, I guess. One of them is Duraludon, because seriously, why does it turn into a skyscraper? What is the connection between Duraludon, a metal dragon that looks like a cross between a lighter and a chair, and a skyscraper? But the ones that bother me the most are Flapple and Appleton, and yeah, a big part of that is that they have the same G-Max form. But the fact that they're both inside a syrupy apple also makes no sense. Flapple has hollowed out and cracked open the apple, so why is it whole again and all syrupy? But even worse is that Appleton doesn't even have an apple anymore, or the worm-like body, so it's like it's reversing its entire evolution. It's more like this is a G-Max Applin rather than Flapple or Appleton. Thankfully, not every G-Max form goes down this path, although there are still others that are bad, just for different reasons. A few of them just don't really change enough, I think. Eevee, Pikachu, even Meowth and Lapras to a degree, but Corviknight especially? Those are just the original designs with some slight modifications, so I just find them boring. But there are some G-Max forms that I actually like. Both Butterfree and Machamp manage to avoid that silly over-the-top look. Both of them change enough and actually make good use of their size as part of the design, and in a way that still makes sense with the original forms as well. Centiscorch may actually be my favorite G-Max. I love that it turns into a huge dragon. It's like an exaggerated Centiscorch, but not in a way that feels like it's too much. Again, using that size in a really good way. Although I'm not a big fan of that radiator coil shape that it takes on when it attacks. And there are a few of those silly over-the-top designs that I think are actually successful, even though I don't like the approach. Gengar being a portal to the afterlife, or Orbeetle being a UFO, both are silly takes and definitely over-exaggerated, but they make sense with the progression of those entire families. And Snorlax is really clever. A Pokemon that is known for sleeping and blocking off paths has basically slept long enough and grown enough that it has basically become the path. So, yeah, definitely a silly idea, but one that really works well for this Pokemon. So I guess the TLDR version is that I wish there was more lore. I still think that it's unnecessary, but at least it was implemented decently well. And the G-Max designs are not my cup of tea, but at least there's some of them that work out well. Overall, at least an improvement over Z-moves. Let me know your thoughts on Dynamax and Gigantamax, and which ones are the best and worst Gigantamax designs in your opinion. Thank you for watching, and thank you all for your support in the past couple of months. My stint of making two videos per week is coming to an end, so if you want to hear more about my plans for the coming months, I've made a separate video just for that. It is unlisted, so you'll only see it if you want to, but there's a link to it in the description and in the end card. One final thank you to my patrons, especially luxury patron Ethan Saffron. I'm Umbreon Libris, I'll see you in the next chapter.